Hi my dear students, I welcome you all for the video class. Today I am going to teach you Civics Chapter 5 Panchayati Raj. In this chapter we will discuss about Gram Sabha, then Gram Panchayat, and the third main thing is three levels of panchayats. Okay children, before entering the session I will ask one question. Okay children, our government functions at three main levels, isn't it? What are the three main levels children? Yes, one is central government, that is central level, then local level, then state level. Clear? Okay children, what are the things comprises in this central government? Yes, the central government of India deals with the matters of national importance. What are the importance? Such as you may know that defense, then foreign affairs, national finance, then railways, then postal service and so on. These are comes under what children? Yes, central government. Okay, then state level, state government. It looks after the issue at the state level, like maintaining law and order, then providing education, then transport and health services and so on. It is inside the state. Okay. Okay children, then what is mean by local level governments? Yes, it deals with the local level problems or needs. Clear? The local people elect their own representatives to form the local government of an area. Clear? What is mean by local, then what central, then state? State level is with state level the central government of India deals with the matters of national importance. What are the important issues or important things? Defense, then foreign affairs, then national finance, railways, then postal service and so on. Clear? Then state level, it looks after the issues at the state level, like the maintaining law and order, then providing education, then transport, then health services and so on. It is inside the state. Okay, then last one is local. In that local, local government is also in two types. First, what is mean by local government? It deals with the problems, local problems or needs. Clear? The local people elect their own representatives to form the local government of a particular area. Clear children? It is two types, the local government divided into two types. What are the local governments you may know children? Yes, one is rural local government, another one is urban local government. Clear children? In this chapter mainly we will discuss about the rural local government. Clear children? Okay children, at first we will discuss about the Panchayati Raj system. Clear? Okay children, what is mean by Panchayati Raj system? Children, it is nothing but it is a process through which this process people in the rural areas participate in their own government. That's all. Clear? What is that? Again you have to tell. It is a process through which people in the rural areas participate in their own government. The main aim of the Panchayati system is to provide more and more space for people to participate in the government. They raise their voices for issues concerning them. Clear children? This is the main aim of the Panchayati Raj. Okay children, next one is Panchayati Raj is a three tier system. Okay children, what is mean by three tier system? Three tier is nothing but includes three main levels, that is three tier. Clear children? The Panchayati Raj is a three tier system which includes three levels. What are they? Yes, first one is Gram Panchayat at the village level. Then Janpad Panchayat or Panchayat Samiti at the block level. Then the third main thing is District Panchayat or Zilla Parishad at the district level. Clear, children? Normally, the Gram Sabha meetings begins with the Panchayat president, who is called as Sarpanch. And the members of the Panchayat, they are called as Panch. Okay, clear? What is mean by Sarpanch? Then Panch. The meeting begins with the president. The president is called as Sarpanch. Then the members of the Panchayat are called Panch. Clear? Children, then one main thing is Gram Panchayat. Gram Panchayat comes under which level, children? Yes, village level. It is categorized into again three types. What are they means? Gram Sabha, then Gram Panchayat, then Nyaya Panchayat. Clear, children? First thing is rural level government, that is Panchayati Raj, is divided into three types. What are they? One is three levels. What are they? Village level, then block level, then district level. Again, the village level is classified into three types. One is Gram Sabha, then Gram Panchayat, then Nyaya Panchayat. Clear? Okay, children. First, we will discuss Gram Panchayat or Panchayat. The Panchayat system is very old in India. The word Panchayat means a group of five people. Clear? Panchayat system is a very old system in India. The word Panchayat means a group of five people. The villager elect a group of five elders as Panchs. What is the main aim of this means? They are used to deal with the local problems and resolve the disputes among the villagers. Clear? Then they are taking decisions that were binding upon all the villagers. Before the independence, it is very less effective. Why? Because the British send their officials to look after the rural problems. After the independence only, it gained more importance. In 1992, the central government formulated the rules of the Panchayati Raj system. Then it became more effective from the April 1993. Clear, children? Gram Panchayat is mainly classified into three types. What are they, children? Yes, Gram Sabha, then Gram Panchayat, then Nyaya Panchayat. Clear? First, we will discuss about the Gram Sabha. Okay, children, what does mean by Gram Sabha? Yes, Gram Sabha is a meeting of all the adults who live in the area covered by a Panchayat. Clear, children? What does mean by Gram Sabha? Gram Sabha is a meeting of all adults who live in the area covered by the Panchayat. Okay, children, who are considered as adults? A citizen who is 18 years old or more. That citizen name is in the voter list, isn't it? So they are called as adults. At the age of 18 or more, they are the member of the Gram Sabha. Clear? Gram Panchayat is a type of meeting where people directly participate and seek answers from their own elected representatives. Clear, children? Then it holds meetings at least twice in a year. Then the Gram Sabha acts as a Lok Sabha in the center and the Legislative Assembly in the state. Okay, children, next we will discuss importance or functions of Gram Sabha. Gram Sabha elects the representatives who form the Gram Panchayat. These representatives look after the day-to-day working of the Panchayat. Clear, children? It elects the representatives who form the Gram Panchayat. Then these representatives look after the day-to-day working of the Panchayat. Then the Gram Sabha also elects the सरपंच आर हेड ऑफ द ग्राम पंचायत और द विलेज हेड मैन आर मुखिया. Either male or female, that doesn't matter. They presides the over the meetings of the Gram Sabha. Then the third main thing is it discusses the important matters and problems regarding the village. It is a platform where all the plans for the working of the Gram Panchayat are placed before the people. It is a platform where all the plans for the working of the Gram Panchayat are placed before the people. Next one, it makes the Gram Panchayat accountable to the persons who elect the members of the Panchayat. Clear children? Which makes Gram Sabha makes the Gram Panchayat accountable to the persons who elect the members of the Panchayat. Then next one, then the Gram Sabha can pass the vote of no confidence against any member of the Gram Panchayat if it is dissatisfied with the work of that member. As a result, the Panchayat member will have to resign. Are you understand this point, children? The Gram Sabha can pass a vote of no confidence against any member of the Gram Panchayat if it is dissatisfied with that work of that particular member. As a result, the Gram Panchayat member will have to resign their job. Clear? Then again the new member will be elected for that place. Next point, it maintains and promotes the social harmony. Clear? It involves the voluntary work in different social programs. Then all members should attend the Gram Sabha meetings. In this way, they can raise their problems, then find their solutions and participate the local democratic government. Clear, children? What I am conveying? Clear? Mainly it maintains and promotes the social harmony. It mainly involves the voluntary work in different social programs. Then all members should attend the Gram Sabha meetings. By this way, they can raise their problems and find their solutions and participate in the local democratic government. Clear, children? We'll move on to next topic. Next one is Gram Panchayat. What is the use of Gram Panchayat, children? The Gram Panchayat is an elected body of the villagers. It implements the decisions taken by the Gram Sabha. Clear, children? What is the use of Gram Panchayat? A Gram Panchayat is an elected body of the villagers. Mainly, it implements the decisions taken by the Gram Sabha. Every Panchayat is divided into smaller areas. That is called as wards. Clear, children? Every Panchayat is divided into smaller areas. The smaller areas called wards. Each ward elect a representative who is known as the ward member or panch. Clear? Each ward elects a representative who is known as ward member or panch. The members of the Gram Sabha directly elect a sarpanch who is the president of the panchayat. The members of the Gram Sabha directly elect a sarpanch who is the president of the panchayat. Clear, children? First, what is mean by Gram Panchayat? Yes, Gram Panchayat is an elected body of the villagers. It implements the decisions taken by the Gram Sabha. Then, what is mean by wards, children? Yes, every panchayat is divided into smaller area. That areas are called as wards. Each ward elect a representative who is known as the ward member or panch. Then what is meant by Sarpanch? As the member of the Gram Sabha directly elects a Sarpanch who is the president of a Panchayat. Clear? Do you know the difference between Panch and Sarpanch? Then the all ward members and the Sarpanch are directly elected by the members of the Gram Sabha. Clear? All the ward members and Sarpanch, that president also directly elected by the members of the Gram Sabha. Then the State Election Commission conduct these type of elections. All these elected people form the Gram Panchayat. Then the Gram Panchayat is elected for every 5 years. Okay children, what is the functions, main functions of Gram Panchayat? Yes, first one is mainly it looks the constructions and maintenance of water sources, roads, drainage, school buildings and other common property resources. Clear? It looks after the construction of roads, maintenance of water resources, drainage, then school buildings and other common property resources. It imposes and collects local taxes. Then mainly it provides the health and sanitation facilities. Clear children? Then it controls the spreading of diseases by vaccination. Then it implements the government programs related to the employment generation and poverty alleviation. Gram Panchayat have so many functions. It provides primary education in the village, then it maintains the records of birth and death in the village, then helps farmers to develop and improve their farms and cattle, then it helps in providing the good quality of seeds and fertilizers, then it organizes the cattle fairs and village fairs. Okay children, next we'll discuss the source of income of the Gram Panchayat. Clear? Gram Panchayat obtains the funds from the collection of taxes on house, then marketplaces, then fairs and so on. Mainly it receives the government scheme funds through various departments of the government, through the Janpad and the Zilla Parishad. Then it also receives the donations for community works. Clear? Then it obtains the fees for registering the purchase and sale of cattle, then land and other properties. Clear children? Okay children, what is the link between Gram Sabha and Gram Panchayat? Then what is the difference between Gram Sabha and Gram Panchayat? Then what is mean by Gram Sabha? Then what is mean by Gram Panchayat? First one is Gram Sabha. Gram Sabha is a meeting of all adults who live in the area covered by the Panchayat. Clear children? Gram Sabha. Then Gram Panchayat. Gram Panchayat is an elected body of the villagers. Clear? Each Panchayat is divided into smaller areas that are called as wards. Then what is the link between Gram Sabha and Gram Panchayat? Okay, we'll see the links. The Gram Sabha elects the members of the Gram Panchayat. Next, the Gram Panchayat is responsible to the Gram Sabha. Clear? These are the links between the Gram Sabha and Gram Panchayat. In a Gram Sabha, all plans for the working of the Gram Panchayat are placed before the people. What is the first point, children? The Gram Sabha elect the members of the Gram Panchayat. Then the Gram Panchayat is responsible for the Gram Panchayat is responsible to the Gram Sabha. Clear? Next, third point, in a Gram Sabha, all plans for the working of the Gram Panchayat are placed before the people. Next one is the Gram Sabha prevents the Panchayat from doing wrong things. Then the Gram Panchayat has a secretary who is also the secretary of the Gram Sabha. Clear? These are the link between the Gram Sabha and a Gram Panchayat. These things are not in your book. Please make a note of it. Okay, children, next one is difference. What is the difference between Gram Sabha and a Gram Panchayat? What is the difference? Yes, first one is the Gram Sabha acts as a legislative body, whereas the Gram Panchayat is an executive body at the village level, isn't it? The Gram Sabha acts as a legislative body, whereas the Gram Panchayat is an executive body at the village level. Next one is, all the adult members of the Panchayat forms the Gram Sabha, while the elected representatives of the Gram Sabha form the Gram Panchayat. Clear, children? Are you understand or not? All the adult members of the Gram, adult members of the Panchayat forms the Gram Sabha, while the elected representatives of the Gram Sabha form the Gram Panchayat. The Gram Sabha takes decisions and Gram Panchayat implements them. Clear? Then the Gram Sabha reviews the work of the Gram Panchayat. The Gram Sabha can pass a vote of no confidence against the inefficient members of the Gram Panchayat. Clear, children? Do you know the difference between Gram Sabha and Gram Panchayat? Then we'll discuss the three levels of Panchayat. Clear, children? Okay, children, what are the three levels of Panchayat? Yes, first one is Nyaya Panchayat, then second one is Panchayat Samiti, then third one is Zilla Parishad. Children, the three levels of Panchayat I tell you detailly, so please make a note of it. First level is Nyaya Panchayat. Nyaya Panchayat is a judicial wing of the Panchayat Raj system at village level, isn't it? Yes. What is the term of service of the Nyaya Panchayat system? Yes, surely 5 years. Very good. Then the members are elected the same as the members of the Gram Panchayat. Clear, children? Nyaya Panchayat hears and decides the minor civil and criminal cases. It can fine and punish the guilty within a certain limits, but it cannot send a person to jail. The main purpose of the Nyaya Panchayat is to provide the speedy justice at the minimum expenses. What is the main purpose of Nyaya Panchayat, children? Is to provide the speedy justice at the minimum expenses. Clear? Next one is Panchayat Samiti. What is the use of it? Panchayat Samiti is also called as what, children? Yes, Janapat Panchayat or the Block Samiti. What is the work of it? It works at the block level. So it is called as Block Samiti. Clear? Panchayat Samiti has some elected members. The term of service is how many years, children? Again, 5 years only. Some seats are reserved for the scheduled caste and scheduled tribes. Clear? And other only the backward classes. 1/3 of the total seats are reserved for women. Apart from the elected members, the Panchayat Samiti also has some ex-officio members, such as who? Sarpanch, then MLAs, then MPs, who are elected from the block. The members of the Panchayat Samiti elect a chairperson known as Pramukh. Clear, children? The Block Development Officer, that is BDO, acts as a secretary of the Panchayat Samiti. Clear? Again, one time I'll repeat. Panchayat Samiti. Panchayat Samiti has many panchayats under it. It is also called as what, children? As Janapat Panchayat or the Block Samiti. What is the work of it? It works at the block level. Okay. Next, what are the composition? We'll see. Some seats, the term of services again for 5 years, this also. Then, some seats are reserved for the which caste children? Yes, first one is scheduled caste. Some seats are reserved for SCs and STs and other backward classes. Then, 1/3 of the total seats are reserved for women. Apart from the elected members, the Panchayat Samiti also has some ex officio members such as Sarpanch, that is Mukhyas, then MLAs and MPs who are elected from the block. Then the members of the Panchayat Samiti elect a chairperson known as Pramukh. The block development officer acts as a ward, yes, acts as a secretary of the Panchayat Samiti. Clear, children? Then what are the main functions of Panchayat Samiti, children? Panchayat Samiti supervises the working of the Gram Panchayats in a block. Then second one, it makes plan for the development of the whole block. Then it has a team of experts in various fields who guide the villagers over different development issues. Next one, it arranges funds from the government for development programs. Clear, children? Again, one time repeat, what are the functions of Panchayat Samiti? First one, the Panchayat Samiti supervises the working of the Gram Panchayats in a block. Then it makes plans for the development of the whole block. Then it has a team of experts in various fields who guide the villagers over different development issues. Clear? At last, it arranges the funds from the government for development programs. Okay, children, are you clear? We'll move on to next one. Next one is Zilla Parishad. Zilla Parishad is also known as what, children? Yes, district panchayat is also known as Zilla Parishad. It's the highest governing body under the Panchayati Raj system. Clear, children? Again, on time tell. It is the highest governing body under the Panchayati Raj system. Clear? Then it works at which level, children? It works at the district level. The people of a district directly elect members of the Zilla Parishad for the term of how many years? Yes, absolutely 5 years. The reservation policy is same as applied in the Gram Panchayat and the Panchayat Samiti. The members of the Jilla Parishad elect a president and a vice president from among themselves. Clear? The members of a Jilla Parishad elect the members, elect the president and vice president from among themselves. The president presides over the meetings of Zilla Parishad. Then the officer of the rank of a district magistrate is the chief executive officer of the Zilla Parishad. Children, are you understand or not? Okay, children, what is the main functions of the Zilla Parishad? Yes, it supervises the working of the Panchayat Samitis and the Gram Panchayats and the projects under the 5-year plans. Next one, it makes the development plans at the district levels. Then it regulates the money distribution among all the Gram Panchayats with the help of Panchayat Samitis. Clear? Then last one is, last main function is, it advises the state government on the working of the Panchayati Raj system. Okay, children, again one time I will repeat. What is the main function? It supervises the working of the Panchayat Samitis and the Gram Panchayats and the projects under the 5-year plans. Then it makes the development plans at the district level. Then third one, it regulates money distribution among all the Gram Panchayats with the help of Panchayat Samitis. Clear? Then last one is, It advises the state government on the working of the Panchayati Raj system. Clear, children? Okay, children. Shall I give a quick revision about the chapter number 5, Panchayati Raj? Children, what we discussed first, our government functions at 3 main levels. What are the levels? One is central, then state, then local level. What is that central government? Yes, the union or the central government of India deals with the matters of the national importance, such as what are they? Defense, then foreign affairs, then national finance, then railways, then postal services, and so on. Okay, children. Next one is state government level. It looks after the issues is at the state level, like maintaining law and order, then providing education, then transport, then health services inside the state, within the state. Okay. Next one is local government. Local government mainly deals with the local problems or needs. Local people elect their own representatives to form the local government of an area. Clear? The local government is also divided into two types. What are they, children? Yes. First one is rural local government, then urban local government. In this chapter, we will discuss about the rural local government in that Panchayati Raj system. The local government at the rural level functions under the Panchayati Raj system. Clear, children? The government, local government at the rural level functions under the Panchayati Raj system. This is a process through which people in the rural areas participate in their own government. Clear? Mainly the rural government Panchayati system, rural local government or Panchayati Raj system, is classified into three types. What are the children? First one is Gram Panchayat, then Panchayat Samiti, then Zilla Parishad. Clear, children? Gram Panchayat at village level, then Panchayat Samiti at block levels, then the Zilla Parishad at district levels. Clear, children? Okay, children, first we will revise the Gram Panchayat. The Panchayat system is very old in India. Do you know that? Clear? Then, what is the meaning for Panchayat? Yes, Panchayat means a group of 5 people. Clear? The village elders. The villagers elect a group of 5 elders as Panch. Clear? Then, the Panchayati Raj system at the village level consists of 3 main bodies. What are they? First one is Gram Sabha, then second one is Gram Panchayat, and the third one is Nyaya Panchayat. Clear, children? First we will discuss Gram Sabha. Children, what is mean by Gram Sabha? Gram Sabha is a meeting of all adults who live in the area covered by a Panchayat. Clear? Then what are the importance and functions of Gram Sabha, children? Yes, first, what are the main function? It elects the representatives who form the Gram Panchayat. These representatives look after the day-to-day working of the Panchayat. Then it is a main thing. Then it also elects the Sarpanch or head of the Gram Panchayat or village. The main thing is Gram Sabha elects the Sarpanch. Who is called as Sarpanch? As the head of the Gram Panchayat or the village headman or the Mukhya. Then the Gram Sabha mainly discuss the important matters and problems regarding the village. It is a platform where all plans for the working of the Gram Panchayat are placed before the people. Clear? It makes the Gram Panchayat accountable to the persons who elect the members of the Panchayat. Clear, children? Then, what are the things it prevents? Means it prevents the Panchayat from doing wrong things such as misusing money, corruption, favoring certain people and so on. Clear, children? What are the functions? It maintains and promotes the social harmony. It involves the voluntary works in the different social programs. Then all members should attend the Gram Sabha meetings. They can raise their problems, then find their solutions and participates in the local democratic government. Are you understand, children? We'll move on to next one. Next one is Gram Panchayat. Gram Panchayat is an elected body of the villagers. It implements the decisions taken by the Gram Sabha. Clear, children? The Gram Sabha, Gram Panchayat is an elected body of the villagers. It implements the decision taken by the Gram Sabha. Clear? Then it acts as an executive body of the Sabha. Clear? Then every panchayat is divided into smaller areas that are called as ward. Yes, wards. Every panchayat is divided into smaller areas are called as wards. Each ward elects a representative who is known as the ward member or panch. Then sarpanch, the members of the Gram Sabha directly elect a sarpanch. Who is the sarpanch? Is the president of the panchayat. Children, who elects the sarpanch? Gram Sabha directly elects sarpanch. Sarpanch is who? Who is a member, who is the president of the panchayat. Clear, children? What is the main function of Gram Panchayat, children? Yes, it looks after the construction and maintenance of water sources, then roads, then drainages, then school buildings and other common properties. Then it imposes and collects the local taxes. The main thing it provides is health and sanitation facilities. Clear? It organizes the cattle fairs and village fairs, then provides the primary education in the village, then it maintains the records of birth and death in the village, then it helps the farmers to develop and improve their farms and cattle, then it also helps in providing the good quality seeds and fertilizers. Then it controls the spread of diseases by vaccination. Okay, children, what is the link between Gram Sabha and Gram Panchayat? As Gram Sabha elect the members of the Gram Panchayat. The Gram Panchayat is responsible for the Gram Sabha. Clear? Okay, children, what is the difference between Gram Sabha and a Gram Panchayat? First, Gram Sabha acts as a legislative body, whereas the Gram Panchayat is an executive body at the village level. Clear? What is that? Gram Sabha acts as a legislative body, whereas the Gram Panchayat is an executive body at village level. Then, all the adult members of the Panchayat forms the Gram Sabha, while the elected representative of the Gram Sabha form the Gram Panchayat. Are you clear, children? Next, we'll discuss the three levels of Gram Panchayat. First one is Nyaya Panchayat, then second one is Panchayat Samiti, then third one is Zilla Parishad. Nyaya Panchayat is a judicial wing of what, children? Yes, Panchayati Raj system at village level. Then term of service of Nyaya Panchayat is how many years? Yes, 5 years. The members are elected in the same way as the members of the Gram Panchayat. Clear? Okay, children, next we'll discuss Panchayat Samiti. The Panchayat Samiti is also what, children? Yes, is also called as Janpat Panchayat or the Block Samiti. Clear? It works at which level? It works at the block levels. Clear? Okay, children, what is the main function of Panchayat Samiti? Yes, Panchayat Samiti supervises the working of the Gram Panchayats in a blocks. Clear? It makes plans for the development of the whole block. It arranges funds for the funds from the government for development programs. Then at last we discuss the Zilla Parishad. Zilla Parishad is also known as what, children? Yes, the district panchayat are also known as Zilla Parishad, the highest governing body under the Panchayati Raj system. It works at which level? Yes, it works at the district level. Children, what is the main function of the Zilla Parishad? Yes, it supervises the working of the panchayat committees, then panchayat, the gram panchayat, and the projects under the 5-year plans. Then it makes the development plans at the district levels. It regulates the money distribution among all the gram panchayat with the help of what? Yes, with the help of panchayat samitis. Children, I hope you all understand this chapter clearly. We'll see in next video class. Thank you, students.